Today, Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will discuss and give lecture on the strategic evolution and control. Strategic evolution and control is the final phase in the process of the strategic management. It is the final phase of the process of the strategic management. Its basic purpose is to ensure that the strategy is achieving the goals and objectives set for the strategy. It compares performance with the desired results and provides the feedback necessary for the management to take the corrective action. According to Fred R. David, strategy evolution includes three basic activities: examining the underlying base of the firm's strategy, comparing expected results with the actual results, and taking corrective action to ensure that performance conforms to the plan. Sometimes the base formulated strategy becomes obsolete as a firm's external and internal environments change. Managers should therefore identify important milestones and set strategic thresholds to assist them in knowing the changes in the underlying assumption of a strategy and, if necessary, after the basic strategic direction. The evolution process thus works as an early warning system for the organization. Strategic evaluation generally operates at the two levels, strategic and operational level. At the strategic level, managers try to examine the consistency of the strategy with the environment. At the operational level, the focus is on finding how a given strategy is effectively pursued by the organization. For this purpose, different control systems are used both at the strategic and the operational level. Nature of the strategic evolution and control. Strategic evolution and control is defined as the process of determining the effectiveness of a given strategy in achieving the organizational objective and taking corrective action whenever required. According to Pierce and Robinson, strategic control is concerned with the tracking a strategy as it is being implemented, detecting problems or changes in underlying premises, and making necessary adjustments. In contrast to post-action control, strategy control seeks to guide action on behalf of the strategy as they are taking place and when the end result is still several years off. Strategy control in an organization is similar to what the steering control in a ship. Steering keeps a ship, for instance, stable on its course. Similarly, the strategy control system sends so that the extent the strategy are successful in attaining goals and objective, and this information is fed to the decision maker for taking corrective action in time. Strategic managers can steer the organization by instituting minor modification or resort to more drastic changes, such as altering the strategic direction altogether. The strategic control system thus offer a framework for tracking, evaluating, or reorienting the functioning of the firm's strategy. Types of the general control system. Basically, there are three types of the general control system: output control, behavior control, and the input control. Output control means the control on actual performance result. Behavior control means control on activity that generate the performance. Input control means control on resources that are used in the performance. Output control. Output control specifies what is to be accomplished by focusing on the end result. This control is done through the setting objective, target, or milestone for each division, department, section, and executive, and measuring actual performance. These controls are appropriate when specific output measures have been agreed on. Often, rewards and incentives are linked to the performance goals. Example: sales quota, specific cost reduction or the profit target, milestones or deadlines for the completion of the project are example of the output control. Behavior control. Behavior control specifies how something is to be done. This control is done through the policy, rules, standard operating practices, and orders from the superiors. These controls are the most appropriate when performance results are here to measure. Rules standardize the behavior and make outcome predictable. If employees follow rules, then actions are performed and decisions handled the same way time and again. The result is predictability and accuracy, which is the aim of the control system. The main mechanism of the behavior control are operating budgets, standard operating practices, rules and procedures. Examples. One example of an increasingly popular behavior control is the ISO 9000 standard series on quality management and assurance developed by the International Standard Association of Geneva, Switzerland. The ISO 9000 series is a way of documenting a company's quality operation and strictly complying with it. Many corporations worldwide view ISO 9000 certification as assurance that the firm sells quality products. Input control. Input control specifies the amount of the resources such as knowledge, skills, ability of the employee to be used in the performance. These controls are most appropriate when output is difficult to measure. Basic characteristics of effective evaluation and the control system. Effective strategy evaluation system must meet the several basic requirements. They must be simple, economical, meaningful, timely, truthful, selective, flexible, suitable, reasonable, objective, acceptable, foster understanding and trust, and fix responsibility of the failure. Effective strategy evaluation system must meet the several basic requirements. They must be simple. Strategic evaluation system must be simple, not too comprehensive and not too restrictive. Complex system often confuse people and accomplish little. The taste of an effective evaluation system is its simplicity, not its complexity. Strategic evaluation activity must be economical. Too many controls can do more harm than good. Meaningful strategic evaluation activity should be meaningful. They should specifically relate to a firm's objective. They should provide manager with useful information about tasks over which they have control and influence. Timely strategy evolution and activity should provide timely information. For example, when a firm has diversified into a new business by acquiring another firm, evaluating information may be needed at the frequent interval. Time dimension of a control must coincide with the time span of the event being measured. Truthful strategy evolution should be designed to provide a true picture of what is happening. Information should facilitate action and should be directed to those individuals who need to take action based on it. Selective, the control system should focus on the selective criteria like any important factors which are critical to performance. Insignificant derivation need not be focused. Flexible, they must be flexible to take care of the changing circumstances. Suitable control system should be suitable to the needs of the organization. They must conform to the nature and niche of the job and area to be controlled. Reasonable control standard must be reasonable. Frequent measurement and rapid reporting may frustrate the control. Objective, a control system should be effective only if unbiased and impersonal. It should be subjective and arbitrary. Otherwise, people may resent them. Acceptable control will not work unless they are acceptable to those who apply them. Foster understanding and trust. Control system should dominate decision, rather they should be foster mutual understanding, trust and common sense. No department should fail to cooperate with the another in evaluating the control of the strategy. Fix responsibility for the failure. An effective control system must fix responsibility for failure. Detecting deviation would be meaningless unless one knows where they are occurring and who is responsible for them. Control system should pinpoint what corrective action should be needed. There is no ideal strategy evolution in control system. The design depends on the unique characteristic of organization size, management style, purpose, and problems and the strengths. These are about the strategic evolution and control. Strategic evolution and the control. Different types of the control system, nature of the strategic evaluation and control, what are the strategic evaluation and control